Good morning, BUHS. Today is Thursday, February 27, 2020.
5, 4, 3, 2.
On February 29th at 7:05, the UVM Catamount hockey team will be playing the Northeastern Huskies at Gutterson Fieldhouse at 147 Spear Street, Burlington, Vermont.
Come to Memorial Park on Saturday for Family Fun Day from 12 to 4. Come to our annual celebration for our fabulous ski hill and the community who supports it. We'll have hot dogs, music, fire pit, s'mores, and prizes for the best costume.
Sounds pretty nice.
Does sound pretty neat.
Stop by the cheese counter every day in March and take part in Vermont Cheese Madness. Each day you'll have the opportunity to taste and judge two cheeses. Vote for your favorite and be a part of that day's winning cheese at the Brattleboro Food Co-op. Now on to weather with weatherman Mason Ford.
Alright, we got a 3-day forecast with you. Starting off Friday, it's partly cloudy, 534 with a low of 19. We're going to go back or move on to Saturday, where it's going to be partly cloudy, high of 31 and a low of 15. Finally, Sunday, it's going to be sunny with a high of 35 and a low of 18. Back to the desk.
For BUHS and Windham County students with a demonstrated financial need, the Experiment in International Living, a program of world learning in Brattleboro, is offering full tuition scholarships exclusive of international airfare for summer 2020 experiment programs. Programs are filling fast. Please apply online at this web address. Before Monday, March 2nd, students will also need to fill out a need-based scholarship application. Complete information can be found by emailing info@experiment.org.
Head over to Mount Snow, Sunday, March 1st, for the Fiddlehead Jack Jump World Championship. Speed, great racing, fantastic crashes, and a ton of fun make the Jack Jump World Championship a can't-miss event. The first place finisher for male and female categories will each receive a $200 cash prize.
Wow.
That's a lot of money there, boy.
That's a lot of smackaroonies.
A lot of smackaroonies. The event is held on Charlie's Chase and is free to watch. The competition begins at 12:30 and awards start at 3:30.
Live music on Cousin's Deck at Mount Snow on February 29th at Mount Snow. Come enjoy the fresh energy and unique selection of some of the biggest hits of all time performed by the OMG band from 12:30 to 4 on the Cousin's Deck stage in the main bass area. Sounds like a good time.
Sounds like a great time, honestly. Yeah. Do you think you're going to go?
Maybe. You never know.
You might. You never know.
Never
know. Tune in to sports updates with Dylan.
In the NBA, the Boston Celtics beat Utah Jazz
114-103. And during the Daytona 500, NASCAR driver Ryan Newman suffered a head injury in a horrific crash during his final lap. And Connecticut Republicans plan to honor the three high school girls who have filed a lawsuit seeking to block transgender athletes from participating in women's sports, claiming trans competitors have a biological advantage. And the coronavirus is threatening the 2020 Tokyo Olympic Games. Members of the International Olympic Committee estimate there's a 3-month window to decide whether or not to cancel them. And back to the desk.
Gordon Meinhard, The Lives of Table, is on view at Brattleboro Museum and Art Center through March 7th, 2020. Regular admission is $8 for adults, $6 for seniors, and $4 for students.
And now for the answer to Monday's riddle, which was, we try so hard to get, but when we find it, we throw it away. The answer was boogers.
Boogers, believe it or not.
That's a good riddle.
I don't blame you. I mean, when you were little, did you throw away your boogers?
Oh, of course.
Really? You didn't eat your boogers?
No, I never eat.
Oh, my God. All right, never mind then. So the BUHS Nordic team headed up to Jericho, Vermont for their last race of the season, competing in the statewide skate meet. The meet consisted of a 5K individual skate style race and an intense relay with the top four racers from each team. The BUHS boys were crowned state champions, beating out Mount Anthony Union in second and Champlain Valley Union taken third. The BUHS girls finished in fifth place overall with Champlain Valley Union crowned as state champs.
If you have good hygiene and like to use soap, I know I do. Come and join an herbalist at Hannah Grimes Center in Keene, New Hampshire on February 29th at 6:30 to 8:30 to learn how to make your own soap. The cost of the class is only $35.
Do you think Shaq will be there to teach us how to make Old Spice?
That'd be pretty sweet.
If Shaq was there, I would show.
No, you mean Terry Crews.
Yeah, but it used to be Shaq.
Did he really?
Yeah, he always rode on like a
That was the Gold Bond commercial.
Oh my God, that's right. It was Gold Bond. My bad.
Now on to the special about the deadly virus and... Or the deadly coronavirus with Winter and Alexa.
Yeah.
According to World Health Organization, the fight against the coronavirus is at a decisive point.
The World Health Organization chief warns that it would be fatal for any country to assume it will not get cases.
Saudi Arabia is stopping foreign pilgrims from entering the country.
Two or more patients have been tested positive in the UK, bringing the total to 15.
Japan plans to close all schools on March 2nd.
Several European countries have announced new cases, all tracing back to Italy.
Globally, more than 80,000 people in more than 40 countries have been infected.
And that's all for the update. Now back to the desk.
All right,
so we got a couple jokes for you.
Some real knee slappers.
Some real knee slappers right here. So, Jimmy, I sold my vacuum the other day.
Oh, really? Why?
All it was doing was collecting dust.
I mean, that is kind of true.
You got one for me, bud?
Yeah, I got one for you. Why do we tell an actor to break a leg?
Why would we say that? That's kind of mean to say to an actor.
Because every play has a cast. That's a double knee slap.
Dang. All right, so on February 29th from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m., come on down to the Soul Emporium on 35th Main Street in Keene, New Hampshire for some magical leap year mini readings. High vibration goods to feed the soul. Come happy, leave happier. Speaking of being real happy, let's go right on over to Keegan with some funny news to make us even happier.
And down under, an Australian man has successfully cooked a pork roast in the front seat of his car. All he had to do was slap his pork roast in the baking pan and leave it in the front seat of his car. Temperatures were reaching up to 178 degrees.
Oh, wow.
And
in his car?
Yeah, in his car, man.
Was he just chilling in there, just cooking his pot roast?
All it took was 10 hours.
It's a good thing you didn't leave his dog in there. Like, if his dog was in there, he'd have... I'm not
gonna yeah, say so... That. and he reckons that a quiche would take only about 2 hours.
Quiche, isn't that like a...
Only
an
two.
Egg pie.
It's like an egg pie, yes.
Oh, looks my like God, that looks roast. Disgusting.
He actually cut it open to show that it is was it, cooked,
that's
and
not
he
cooked.
Did eat it.
That's so, that's good.
It looks pretty cooked.
That does not look cooked to me.
Are you sure?
Go back to the picture. Can you go back to the picture?
I'd eat that.
Look at that. That looks cooked.
I don't know about that. Looks like a brain. That looks like a monkey brain right there.
That looks like Walmart deli meat. It's all right.
Exactly. Why would you want to eat that?
It's deli meat. It's fine.
I take that car, though. That's a nice looking car.
Hey, food's food, man. You know?
I mean, one. I guess. You put it on a cutting board? Oh, yeah. I guess you put it on there. All right, Jimmy, what you got for us?
So, basically, there's an airport in Denver, Colorado, where basically there's a bunch of conspiracy theories about it. So before this airport was built in, like, the 90s, there was this other airport where they were just like, oh, well, we need to make a new one. So they built five buildings on it, all connected, and then they buried all of them underground.
Buried all of what?
Buried what?
Just those buildings they made, like, fully functional
they
buildings.
They built buildings underground?
Yeah, and then they put them all underground, and then they rebuilt everything.
Oh, okay.
So when they first rebuilt it,
uh-huh.
They basically, like, they had this blue, like, Mustang, like, I don't know how to explain it, like a statue, and it was huge. Whenever it was first being built, the person that was making it, the head slipped off and killed him.
Oh.
And they also say that the blue Mustang also stands for the Four Horsemen of Apocalypse. There are also some weird murals in the Denver airport. There are also, they said there are underground tunnels. There are, capsules, too. They have a time capsule locked till 2094, and they actually have the Freemason logo on there. Do you know what Freemasons are?
Is that the guy from Fallout Boy that goes like this?
No. Okay. Freemasons are basically these people that control everything from, like, the depths of the darkness, where, like, you don't see them, but it's fun. So you don't see them, and they're basically controlling everything that happens, and they're controlling the future.
Okay, I guess
so. They believe that these Freemasons and these people that were involved with this built this airport so that people could go there in, like, a time of need, I'm pretty sure, because there's a mural there. I don't have pictures, but there's a mural there, like, talking about, like, genocide and things like that. Indicating a, like, the end of the world or an apocalypse.
That's pretty dark. Mm-hmm. And they put that in an airport?
Yeah.
I got a question about something you said a little while back.
Mm-hmm.
What's a Mustang?
Like a horse.
And it killed someone?
Yeah, it was like a blue statue.
Big animals.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. It was like a statue.
Oh, it was a statue.
Yeah, and then the head slipped off, and it had a like the horn just...
There's horns on horses?
Or like the front of it. I meant the front of it.
The nose?
Yeah, like the nose was like sharper.
Oh, right. That makes sense. I guess that makes sense.
And then they put it back up.
All right, guys. That's all we got for you guys today. See you next week, and enjoy your 4-day weekend. Woo-hoo.